Hello everyone, in this video we will learn how we can convert Roman numerals to integers. As we know, Roman numerals are represented by a combination of letters, and I have listed down Roman numerals 1 to 10 just for reference. Now let's one by one look at various symbols of Roman numerals and their value in integer form. Firstly, the symbol I has the value 1, the symbol V has the value 5, the symbol X has the value 10, and the symbol L has the value 50. Next, the symbol C has the value 100. The symbol D has the value 500. And finally, the symbol M has the value 1000. Now, in our example, we are considering each symbol to be in uppercase. Now, let's look at the method by which we combine the various symbols to get different values. Suppose we take the symbol V, which represents 5 in Roman numerals. If we add the symbol I to its right, it means that we are adding the value of I to V, which makes it 5 plus 1, that is 6. And similarly, if we add the symbol I to the left of symbol V, this means we are subtracting its value from symbol V. Thus, it makes the overall value as 4. So what we are actually doing here is we are comparing the symbols from right to left. That is, if a symbol with less value comes to the left of a symbol with more value, then we subtract the value of the symbol on the left from the value of the symbol on the right. Otherwise, if the symbol on the left has a value greater than or equal to the symbol on the right, we add their values. So now let's use this basic concept to convert Roman numerals to integer. For this, let's take another example, say the number 79. Which is represented as LXXIX in Roman numerals, and we have to convert this to integer. So firstly, we take the input of this Roman numeral as a string, and then we will loop through the string from right to left, that is from backwards, and we will use a variable p to keep track of the previous value, and we will use another variable answer to store the integer value of the Roman numeral. So what we will do is, while looping through the string from right to left, we will compare the current value with the previous value. And if the current value is smaller than the previous value, then we will subtract it from our answer. And if the current value is greater than or equal to the previous value, we will add it to our answer. So let's actually do this. Firstly, we initialize our variable p and answer to 0. And then we start looping through our string, say using the variable I. Now our first symbol is x, which has the value 10, and if we compare it with the value of p, which is 0, the value of x is greater, so we add it to our answer. Thus our answer becomes 10. And next we assign its value to our variable p so that we can keep track of the previous value while moving forward in our loop. So p now has the value of x, which is 10. Then we move on to the next symbol. And the next symbol is I, which has the value 1. And if we compare it with the value of P, which is 10, the value of I is small. Thus, we subtract it from the answer and our answer becomes 9. Then we assign the value of the current symbol to P, which is 1. And we move on to the next symbol, which is X and has the value 10, which is greater than the value of P, which is 1. So we will add it to our answer. Thus, our answer becomes 19. Then we again update the value of p to the value of current symbol, which is 10. And we move on to the next symbol, which again is x and has the value 10. And when we compare it with the value in p, the value is equal. So we again add its value to our answer and our answer becomes 29. And we update the value of our p, which would again be 10. And finally, we move on to the last symbol, which is L, and has the value 50, which is greater than the value of P. Thus, we add it to our answer and our answer becomes 79, which corresponds to the integer value of this Roman numeral. So now let's implement this using C++ to understand how we will actually do it. So firstly, we need a function value, which will take in as an argument the Roman character and return its integer value. So we will use switch to return various values corresponding to the symbol. That is, if the argument is I, we will return 1. If the argument is v, we will return 5. Similarly, if the argument is x, we will return 10. And if it is l, we will return 50. If it is c, we will return 100. Likewise, if it is d, we will return 500. And finally, if it is m, we will return 1000. So we are using this function to convert the individual Roman symbol to its corresponding integer value. Now let's start with our main function, that is the function which converts Roman to integer, and it takes in as an argument a string a which contains the Roman numeral and returns its integer value. So firstly, let's declare our variable I, n, answer and p. We will use n to store the index of the last symbol, which would be the length of the string minus 1. And then we will use the variable I to loop through the string backwards, that is from right to left, by equating I to the last index. And we will decrement I until we reach the first symbol, which is at index 0. And for every symbol, we will check if the value of that symbol is greater than or equal to p. Then we will add the value of that symbol to answer. And we are generating the value of the symbol using the value function that we created. And if the value of the symbol is less than p, which is the else case, we will subtract the value of that symbol from answer. And then we will update the value of p as the value of current symbol. And we will repeat this process for every symbol. Therefore, when the loop ends, we will have the integer value of the Roman numeral in the variable answer. And we will finally return that variable. So that was all for this video. Thank you for watching.